Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama, and I am on a Greyhound bus. So I'm doing this from my iPad, and that's why I'm talking into this little microphone. And, you know, I'm just riding, you know, and I decided to take the bus because it was like $22 round trip web special, first of all. And I think, you know, like a lot of times I just want time to think, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, driving on a bus is, or a 2-hour ride is a good time to spend time, you know, thinking about things in your life. I know my guy, he wanted to drive me, and it was so funny because when I woke up this morning, I had already made a decision that I was getting ready to go to Chicago. I was going to take a bus, and I didn't want him to drive me because I need time alone. And I think a lot of times we don't want to spend time by ourselves, you know what I'm saying? But I enjoy solitude. I get a lot of enjoyment out of quiet time. And so I'm doing this video just to share my adventure with you today, that I'm going to Chicago to see my cousin that I haven't seen like in about 25 years, who's originally from Louisiana. And she's here in Chicago. She's there in Chicago visiting her mom because they all went to a family reunion, which I didn't go. So, you know, I got the opportunity to go and see her because she was my favorite cousin, my older cousin. You know how you have your favorite older cousins, and she was my favorite older cousin. And I always kind of like looked up to her, even though she didn't hang out with me because I was younger. But, you know, and I was kind of like, wow, you know, I was kind of like on the wild side. You know what I mean? Because I was a runaway and all that other kind of stuff. But I could always seek refuge in that side of my family, you know, my father's people. And so when I found out that she was here, you know, they were on their way back, and they would stop by my dad's because he's in Jefferson City, Missouri. And they had stopped by my dad's and called me and told me that they were on their way back to Chicago and that my cousin was going to be there. And so I told him then, I said, Sunday, I'm rolling up there, you know, even though I got like tons of work to do. But I also need to, you know, spend some time thinking. And my guy, like I said, he wanted to take me, but I didn't roll with him, you know. And so when he found out that I was getting ready to catch the bus, he ran down to the bus station. He came down to the bus station to try to persuade me to ride down to Chicago with him. And I'm like, Baba, I don't want to ride down to Chicago with you. I want to ride the bus by myself. But you know what he said? He said, I'll tell you what then, because he's on his way to Chicago too. He said, I'll tell you what then, I'll bring you back home. Now, I already got a return ticket. He is so funny. I already got a return ticket. You know what I'm saying? I got a round trip. But he said he gonna come to Chicago and bring me home. Now, I don't know if I want to ride back with him or not. That's the whole thing. And that's the whole idea of me taking the bus, is I want some solitude. I don't want to, you know, coming and going. So, you know, I don't know. At this point, I don't know, because, you know, we've had some discussion about some things that's going on. And, you know, I'm really like more looking at myself than looking at him. And how I'm, you know, dealing with this situation. But, you know, he's a good guy. That's all I can say, in his own right. You know what I mean? But, you know, I'm also in my own right too. So. And I'll be trying to see if I'm, you know, selfish or, you know, anything like that. You know, just to, you know, 'cause you got to check your own self. You know, sometimes, because a lot of times it don't be the other person. Sometimes it be you. So that's why, you know, I take time out to do reflection on myself on a constant basis, so that, you know, the karma that I get back is always going to be positive, you know, because I don't want to, you know, put out no negativity, you know, negative karma. I don't want to do that. So, I mean, it's a beautiful day. You know, they got that NATO thing down in Chicago, too. So that's why I'm not getting off at the downtown station. I'm getting off at the 95th and Day and Ryan, so I can circumvent all that NATO stuff, which is why I don't want to ride with him, because he got to go through all that NATO stuff. I don't want to, you know, ride with him and go through all that. So, and plus have to listen to his music, even if I don't want to talk. I have to listen to his radio, and, you know, just the fact that we be in the same ride and the energy is, you know, still there. So, you know, I'm kind of like digging, and I just want to do this video. Because after this video, I'm cutting everything off and I'm just going to contemplate and look at the nature and the scenery along the way. Because they've done a whole lot of building and stuff that, you know, generally I've seen change along the years. So it's a pretty interesting view as far as I'm concerned. But I also wanted to tell you about last Friday and Saturday, Brother Umar Johnson was in Milwaukee. They brought Brother Umar Johnson in, and they've been like bringing people in, you know, for the past 2 or 3 months. And so they brought Brother Umar Johnson on Friday. You know, his dialogue was the same, you know, like everybody else's. What's wrong with us? Why we can't get along? The history of this and the history of education and the history of white folk doing black people this way and that way, and why we ain't succeeding, and why we can't do this, and why we ain't doing that. And you know, from a collective standpoint, I can understand what he's saying. But as I look around the room and I saw all the young people in the room and the doom and gloom of the situation that he, you know, painted for us. And, you know, I think that what it lacks to me is a balance, because all black people aren't doing bad. Like I said, as a collective, we are. But we need to show some examples of people who are doing well. Even some of those young people in that audience is doing well. Because on one hand, he said public education ain't shit. But then on the other hand, he said black men ain't getting high school diplomas. Well, see, to me, that'll be a positive thing if the public school system ain't shit. We just don't have nothing else for them to do. But it seemed like to me, not getting a diploma is not a bad thing if the system that they're getting it from is no good. So to me, that's kind of like doublespeak. I mean, it seemed like to me, you got to make up your mind. Either you're willing to get a diploma from the system that you say that is bad, or, you know, not get them. They're not getting a diploma from that, but something else. And the something else is the key. Now, he also said that we should have our own schools, and I'm like, we do have our own schools. They're the public school system. And if you look at all the urban districts around the country, the majority of the students in those districts are, for the most part, black people. So my thing is, if the dollars allocated to a school district is based on student population, which it is, and we have the majority of students in the school, all we have to do is organize the parents to make demands of that district of what they want for their children, and the school system is yours. I have been witness to the Latino community and how they have took off running when it came to getting what they needed for their children in the realm of education. I'm serious. For the past like maybe 10 years, I've been watching them make moves, okay, and especially in Milwaukee public school system, so I've been seeing it. So, you know, I don't say, you know, that we need to have our own schools. Yeah, I said we need to have our own specialty schools where, you know, once our children leave high school, they can go someplace for training. But I also think that we have the power in our own damn school system. That's what I think, because our children make up the majority. So, you know, the pipe dream of having our own schools is so far in the future, because you got to deal with the psychology of the people right now. You know what I'm saying? But we do have physical places called schools that our children attend that we can commandeer, because we're their parents and we have the last say whether they believe it or not as to what we want and who we want to teach our children and what kind of books we want them to learn out of. We have the power, you know, and that's why we need to take the power. You got school board that you elect. You got a superintendent that's selected by your school board. And I'm saying that the parents are the ones who are in control. But they just don't know it. So once we organize parents, we won't have education problems. That's the deal. The deal is educating parents and mobilizing parents. And you don't need a whole lot of them. You just need representatives that's consistent. So with that, say, look, I got 9 minutes, 27 seconds, and I think you can't put but 10 minutes up on the YouTube on the iPad. So I'm getting ready to go and enjoy the rest of my day. I hope you guys have enjoyed the rest of your day. I love each and every one of you, and I hope to see you very, very soon via YouTube. And remember, June 3rd, my show starts back up on Blog Talk Radio. So I hope to see you there as well. With that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Peace, everybody. Hotep.